Werkzeug aus Remscheid, 12 mm. Die Scheiße ist so schief, die kannst du nur zum Bier aufmachen benutzen. This is Limited X. We want to talk about pain relief and we don't want to die in hospital. And in order to talk about pain relief, by the way, I try to keep this up to 25 minutes. I've made the first choice of folks. Two German ones and a French one, and the English classic BNF, and I want to start with the last one. And before this, I'm going to introduce the two foreign ones, and I'm going to start with a compendium der medikamentösen Schmerztherapie von Springer. Ist in der sechsten Auflage erschienen. It's the sixth edition. It's from 2016, and I think it's quite a good book. You've got quite important information written down you normally don't find in standard medicine books. It's quite thin, it's got 120 pages. Oh, yes, 127. We're gonna use this one a lot. We've got Guide pratique des médicaments, a French book. It's really new. I like it. The problem is with this one, it has there information missing, which are included in the BNF, and I think you absolutely need this one. Pain relief medicine is toxic, it does harm to you, it occurs a lot of dead people who are using pain relief medicine. They cure a lot of people, dead people who use pain relief medicine, and for this reason you need the BMF. I have bought this one used. It's from Selby War Memorial Hospital. I don't want to miss it. And the one I've chosen to talk first about is a patient book. It's from autumn 2017. And yes, it's a patient book. You don't have to be a medicine. It's a patient book. You don't have to be a medicine to buy the book. The price is $29.90. And They've had two other books. This one is quite different. You've got a color system which indicates, I can show the color system. Here you've got a color system which indicates which medicine you should use and you shouldn't use. You've got information for pregnant women, you've got information for children, you don't have information on the price of the medicine. That has been in the previous books, those are missing. There's been complaints about this information, and what I miss is you don't have any pictures included. And on very important medicine, there's information missing. It's quite superficial, and yes, so we're going to talk about pain relief, and I'm going to start with looking up in the chat concerning pain relief, and it's there. We have got pain and fever, and it's page 665. Fever, and we got pain relief, and it starts with quite a lot of text. Ist eine Selbstbehandlung möglich? Germans believe you can cure yourself by going to the pharmacy and just buying by yourself pain relief medicine. You can buy a lot of pain relief medicine in Germany. Even pain relief medicine you wouldn't get in Britain or France or other countries without concerning visiting a physician. And yes. Wann zum Arzt? When to go to the physician? Verstärken sich die Schmerzen innerhalb von vier Tagen? Dauern sie länger an? Kehren sie häufig wieder oder kommen andere Beschwerden hinzu? Sollte in jedem Fall ein Arzt zu Rate gezogen werden. Starke Schmerzen, die zum ersten Mal auftreten und deren Herkunft unerklärlich ist oder anhaltender Schmerz, sollten immer mit einem Arzt besprochen werden. When you should go to a physician if the pain is getting worse during 4 days. If the pain is lasting longer, or if the pain is coming back quite often, or if you've got other illnesses, you should go to a physician. And if you don't know where the pain is coming from and they're quite heavy, you should also go to a physician. Those are the points mentioned in this book. Was ist bei der Behandlung wahr? Kein Schmerzmittel ist harmlos. Daher gilt der Grundsatz, Schmerzmittel wirklich nur bei Bedarf kurze Zeit und individuell angemessen dosiert einnehmen. Die übermäßige Anwendung birgt gesundheitliche Risiken. wenn die Schmerzen längere Zeit mit Medikamenten behandelt werden müssen, den Nutzen und die mögliche möglichen Langzeitschäden sorgfältig abgewogen werden. Aber auch die kurzzeitige Anwendung ist nicht ganz ohne Risiken. So können Schmerzmittel in Einzelfällen schwere allergische Reaktionen hervorrufen. Auch die gängigen rezeptfreien Mittel rufen sie unverzüglich den Notarzt, wenn starker Hautausschlag, Juckreiz, Herzrasen, Atemnot, Schwäche und Schwindel auftreten. Es kann sich um lebensbedrohliche Allergie handeln. What is to say about this one? If you cure your pain with medicines, you should think about that no pain relief medicine is harmless. You should only take those drugs on a short basis of time, matching to the individual situation and on a equivalent dose. If you taking those medicines too often, you've got health risks, really bad health risks, and if you cure your pain on a longer base of time with medicine, you've got to think about Langzeitschäden. The damage that is curing on this longer time you take the medicine. Given short time, concerns, risks. You've got allergic reactions. If you got Hautausschlag, Juckreizen, Herzrasen, Atemnot. Hautausschlag is, you mentioned certain things on his skin, turning red, concerning the bubbles. Juckreiz, you've got Herzrasen is, you've got high frequency of heartbeats, and atemnot is you don't breathe properly. Schwäche und Schwindel, weakness, and you've got problems finding the right point to stand or sit, and you may fall apart. You should immediately call an emergency physician. It may be a life risk allergy. Welche weiteren Behandlungsmöglichkeiten gibt es? What do you have else instead of medicines to cure your illnesses? Yes. You can use psychological therapy, Entspannungsverfahren. Entspannungsverfahren are quite difficult if you've got really strong pain, believe me. I don't think those will really work. You've got to be careful with those. They can even really provocate a higher level of pain, and maybe they've got to rewrite this. Was kann ich selbst tun? What can I do by myself? Bei Kopfschmerzen tut es bisweilen gut, sich in einem abgedunkelten, vor Geräuschen abgeschirmten Raum hinzulegen. Manche Menschen fühlen Erleichterung, wenn sie sich eine Eispackung oder Kaltwasserumschläge auf die Stirn, bei Zahnschmerzen Kühles auf die Wange legen. Regelschmerzen lassen sich häufig mit Wärmelindern, ein Bad, eine Wärmflasche, ein wärmer Wickel. Oft erübrigt sich dann die Blätten einer Arme. Okay, this one is quite easy. You cure your illnesses with, you're trying to sleep or with cold or with warmth. And we've got our pain medicines, and those are quite a lot. We've got rezeptfreie Medikamente, those you can buy on your own in Germany at the pharmacy, and we've got rezeptpflichtige Medikamente. And those are quite heavy. We've got for example, pritrimamid, pethidine, fentanyl, and we've got some mixtures of two medicines. For example, Paracetamol and Codeine. And on the rezeptfreie Medikamente, we've got certain medicines mixed with caffeine, and those are marked red. For example, let me say some names. Neuralgien, quite common in German advertising. Migräne, nee, das ist es nicht. Tomapyrin Classic Intensiv, it's a quite interesting niches marked red concerning caffeine. As I said before, what I could do by myself, and basically you're trying to sleep, and caffeine is not recommended. I don't know why those medicines exist. If you're looking at these medicines, you quite often find ibuprofen, and if you look at ibuprofen, I take it by myself sometimes, the last 50 pills of ibuprofen are, I think I got them 5 months ago, and I've taken about 20 of them. You shouldn't take those too often. It's the German favorite of pain relief medicines, and I want to talk about it first, and I want to look up ibuprofen in those four books, and it may be a good starting point to start with a certain medicine. Okay, so one they start here is acetylsalicylsäure, ISS. It's yes, you can use it. It wouldn't be my first recommendation if you just would acute pain. It can, you can use it in other situation. And the second one is flupirtine. Then we've got metamizole, also green. And we've got NSRAs. And they've got mentioned five NSRAs. Non-steroid, blah blah blah, anti-rheumatic. Yes. In Britain, you know those as NSARs as well. We've got diclofenac, ibuprofen, naproxen, and only four. And dexteprofen. Dexteprofen is quite new. Diclofenac is quite heavy. Naproxen, I don't use it. You might know those. It's quite often recommended for the special days. Yes. It says geeignet bei leichten bis mäßig starken Schmerzen. Mit steigender Dosierung und Dauer der Anwendung steigt das Risiko für unerwünschte Wirkungen. It's recommended for weak pain and not too bad pain. If you go too high on a dose and take it too long, the risk that's occurring will climb to a level you don't want to reach. Especially with ibuprofen, there occurs a lot of poisoning in European hospitals. It's quite dangerous if you don't use it properly. And we've got a bit of text. What is really missing is we've got don't have recommendation on the dose. This has been better in previous books. There's no toxic level occurring, and I haven't read the text yet. I want to read it aloud. And I'm gonna start translating it part by part, so I might learn something about NSRAs. Like, but look how much time I've got left. Only 2 minutes. I don't think I'm going to start reading on the text, see you next week. Yes. Bye. Thank you.